Well, shares in SolGold shot up more than 20% on Monday after it rejected a proposal from BHP Billiton. The FTSE 100 mining company offered to put $305 million on the table to take control of the project in Ecuador. Well, the mining analyst John Meyer from SP Angel joins me on the line. John, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
BHP probably weren't expecting that rejection, were they?
I'm not sure they're used to being rejected by mining companies, but they are used to having to negotiate their way into deals. And although this is a very rare event for an offer from BHP to earn their way into a mining project, it's not entirely unique.
Do you reckon they'll come back with a higher offer?
Well, experience says to us that they would expect a bit of negotiation before final terms were set. And looking at the conditionality of the offer that's been initially proposed, it looks as if they would be looking forward to several months of perhaps protracted negotiation.
Well, look, the board had previously backed an offer from Newcrest Mining and Maxit Capital. How did those offers differ?
There is a difference in price. BHP are offering a higher price, but marginally less money. But BHP are trying to make it look more attractive by offering the potential to spend $275 million more on evaluating the project. So that's a very big number being dangled in front of the board of SolGold, and it's not something you want to walk away from completely.
But really, having a second major mining company show this level of interest must highlight the quality of the project.
It certainly suggests an element of competitive tension, and it will attract the attention of an awful lot more mining companies. There are others in the area, Antofagasta, Rio Tinto, Anglo American, that are also going to run their slide rules over this one yet again.
What sort of mine do you think this could become?
Well, it has the potential to become a very large, mega-scale copper mine in Ecuador. We don't know if it can support or sustain that scale of operation just yet. We still don't have a resource on the project, but what we know is that there are kilometer-long lengths of copper-gold mineralization, and that is something that BHP is clearly quite interested in.
So is it too early to tell whether it could be big enough to affect global copper supply?
No, I don't think it. I think bringing on a mine of this scale would be significant, but there is more than likely to be sufficient demand in the market to create room for a new mine of this scale.
Well, look, just broad brush, how are things for junior miners at the moment?
The junior mining sector is not doing too badly right now. Its investors seem to be returning to the sector. There is a degree of momentum within the space, and it's all going quite well.
Thanks for your analysis, John. Appreciate it.
You're very welcome.